Hi, Carol here from Rolling Pin Media. This is not an unboxing video. It's not a new gear review either. The product itself, Tentacle Sync E, has been with us for a few years now, and the SMPTE timecode has served our industry for about 5 decades. You can obviously use clapperboard, clap your hands, or bipleural eyes that help with multi-track synchronization. All those things work, but SMPTE timecode is probably the best way to improve your post-production workflow. If it's only a few audio and video files that we need to synchronize, our Premiere Pro, Final Cut, or DaVinci have good tools to help us. Just like pleural eyes, they analyze the waveform, and if we have a good reference audio signal in our video, it will do a great job in aligning different sources. No problem there. Well, how about this? And it's only 4 hours worth of rushes where we have used 2 cameras and 1 recorder. When your project is larger, there might be many more files to synchronize. I will show you how to simplify synchronization using German-made Tentacle Sync E generators. But first, let's explain what this TC or a SMPTE timecode actually is. Timecode, standardized by the Society of Motion Picture and Television Engineers, is a timestamp on a media file which can take a form of metadata or a sound recording. Cameras and recorders with good timecode generators that embed metadata in its files are usually top-of-the-range professional tools. In a Tentacle Sync E and other available external generators, we use timecode in the form of a sound recording containing 80-bit code data. It is recorded into a free audio channel via camera or audio recorder. LTC, linear timecode or longitudinal timecode, recorded onto our Zoom H4n or a Tascam, have to be converted into metadata timecode. It's a simple process done with the help of an application, and we'll talk about it in a few minutes. So, in the heart of every timecode generator, whatever the brand, there is a very precise clock. Generated time is frame accurate and recorded as LTC or metadata. Timecode itself is saved as hours, minutes, seconds, and frames. And now the whole mystery of using TC in media production boils down to synchronizing those clocks in all our devices in a process called jamming, so they generate exactly the same frame accurate time for many, many hours. As I said before, professional cameras and recorders have their TC generators built in, although they're not always 100% reliable. With the advent of mirrorless and DSLR cameras in professional video production, we can use external TC generators with a great success. Mind you, in our affordable audio recorders from Tascam or Zoom H series, we need to sacrifice one audio channel. Some cameras and recorders like this Sound Devices MixPre 6 first generation have a timecode reader. They do not generate TC, but they automatically convert audio LTC into metadata. In this case, we don't need to sacrifice any of our audio channels. Generating timecode isn't normally a very power-consuming process. In Tentacle system, most energy is probably drawn by the Bluetooth module, but a fully charged battery will let us use Sync E for about 35 hours, which theoretically means 2 shooting days. Batteries in Sync E and all other Tentacle products are built in. Some people see it as a design weakness, but really it is impossible to run out of juice with a full battery. Also, it only takes about 1.5 hours to fully charge. Tentacle also offers a battery replacement kit. It will be useful after a few years when lithium polymer battery will naturally degrade. The kit itself is reasonably priced and the job can be done safely by the Sync E owner. In a dual kit packed into an eco-friendly box, there are 2 Sync E generators, 2 clamps, 2 USB-C cables, a few rubber bands to color-code the units, 2 short mini-jack cables, self-adhesive Velcros. All of it will fit into a snug, zipped plastic pouch reinforced with a mesh. The housing is entirely made of plastic, which isn't necessarily a bad thing, sorry David Attenborough. Tentacle products have been present in the market for several years now, and nobody seems to be making a fuss or complain about their build quality. And also, thanks to plastic housing, the unit weighs next to nothing. How is the single Sync E generator built? It is tiny. a matchbook size unit. On the front above the logo, or below depending on how you hold it, there is a microphone capsule. This is what differentiates Tentacle from other brands. Our DSLRs or mirrorless cameras record usually two tracks of audio. With the Sync E plugged in, TC is recorded into one channel and the scratch or reference audio into another one, all thanks to this small built-in capsule.
The capsule on the microphone is decent, nothing to write home about, but for scratch audio is enough, as reference track would be fine. In the left channel, you can hear the LTC, linear timecode, and in the right channel, it's me talking.
Here we have USB socket for charging the unit's battery and updating the firmware. LED light is on when charging. At the back, there is a spiky or brushy part of a Velcro, which is integrated with housing. Two LED lights that indicate that TC and Bluetooth are on, and 3.5mm mini jack socket. The manufacturer decided to save some space and probably a bit of cash by not using screw-locking mini jack, like the one we use in body packs. This little smartly designed plastic clamp will secure the connection from accidental unplugging. To turn the Sync E on, we have to hold the switch for a few seconds. When the LED blinks, it means that the unit is on. Mind you, there are two modes, green, in which your unit generates timecode, or the red mode, where it receives timecode from master device. It is an important feature of all timecode generators available on the market. Download Tentacle Setup app for your Android or iPhone. After turning both generators on, thanks to Bluetooth connection, we'll be able to see them in our app. Every new Sync E comes with a generic name. Tentacle, being a German company, decided to use their popular names. Mine were Helga and Rainer. You can obviously change it to use numbers instead. I use colors that correspond with rubber bands included. After clicking Add Device, you can see all Tentacle products within the Bluetooth reach. When you move Sync E unit close to your phone, it will highlight one in the list. It's a smart solution that will help to recognize generators before marking them with colors or numbers. It's probably useful when you have more units. We add our devices, change their names, and we now see them as part of our system. Now, let's synchronize our units. As I said before, we call it jamming. Because I normally use 25 FPS frame rate in my cameras, I choose this here in Tentacle Setup app. There are all standard frame rates available, from 2398 through 2497 drop frame to 30. Although Tentacle doesn't provide us with 50 or 60 FPS, which is a popular frame rate amongst YouTube creators, as long as we choose the FPS value that is a half of our camera frame rate, included software will recalculate the timecode. Now we'll jam our units according to the frame rate. When all our Sync E are highlighted green, it means they are jammed. You can see that both green LED lights are blinking simultaneously too. This warning sign says that there is no mini jack connection. It is helpful because we can later use our app and remotely check if it hasn't disconnected. Let's test it and see what happens. Warning sign has gone. Same with my blue generator. It doesn't, however, warn us that the cable disconnected from the camera, but then you can't have everything. The next step is jamming with my recorder. And this is where I'm not going into details because every recorder in its TC menu is different. I'm using BNC to mini jack cable to jam with my Mixbree 10T. If I had spare Sync, I'd probably use it instead of a Mixbree built-in generator. It is actually more reliable. To demo the system, we'll use actual recordings from a few weeks ago. I have shot some yoga videos from our friend, and after 4 hours on the set, I got back to my studio with several gigabytes worth of video and audio files. It was a two-camera and one-recorder setup. Actually quite small and simple project, but as you can see, there's a decent number of MOV, MP4 and WAVFiles to synchronize and post. Every Tentacle generator kit comes with a license for Tentacle Sync Studio software. It's an uncomplicated yet powerful application that normally would cost €149 if you wanted to buy it from Tentacle website. The reason for them to charge is that it really is a universal tool for any time-coded media files. Although it's a Mac-only software, PC users are not abandoned by the manufacturer. For Windows, you get Tentacle Timecode Tool, which actually is a free software. It's less advanced than Sync Studio, but it will quickly convert LTC audio timecoded files into files containing metadata. The advantage of Sync Studio is that we synchronize our recordings and save a small XML or AAF project files. Those are recognized by video editing software. Let's drag and drop all our media files into the Sync Studio. After a few seconds, not only does it convert LTC into metadata, but it also recognizes your cameras. After clicking Sync Map, you can now see all recordings on the timeline, all nicely synchronized. Because I use Premiere Pro, I'm going to click XML button up here. I choose my parameters, Premiere Pro or Final Cut. Frame rate, video and audio formats. Click Save. If you use Avid, you can choose AAF. Mind you, Media Composer itself can read LTC, and knowing editors who use this system daily, I'm sure they won't bother with Sync Studio. In DaVinci Resolve, we have a pretty good timecode tool as well. After clicking Update Timecode from Audio Track, you can see how DaVinci converts LTC into metadata timecode. Okay, we've got our XML file saved, so let's open a new Premiere project. We drag and drop the XML file into the Project Media window. When we open the sequence, you can see all our video and audio files on the timeline synchronized. Now it's only a tiny matter of editing. Thanks for watching.